Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Kavinsky's Tutorials. So today I want to look at one specific thing that is incredibly unintuitive about this really cool new Alexander Zolotov app called Relic Flow. So first, just briefly, this is similar to his other apps, Relic Waves and Fractal Bits. But Fractal Bits is more for noise, and Relic Waves is more for textures. And this one is more rhythmic stuff. Now, the thing is, the process of creating a folder within which to save files that you have exported inside the AUv3. So I'm, you know, on an iPad here. So if you're an Android user, this will not apply to you because Android doesn't have AUv3, which is basically the iPad or iPhone format for like VST, similar to VST plugins, okay, on desktop, meaning you can load multiple instances and so on. So see, what we might want to do is just export all of these sounds to one folder, and then we've got them there and we can load them in other apps and so on. Now, of course, this being AUv3, we could also just record things into something. So Salome, for example, would be a pretty useful choice for that. Now, I'm not going to bother doing that here. But obviously, there's a lot to be said for just exporting all of these in one go. Now, the unfortunate thing is that the system used to do this is just incredibly arcane. And it really kind of drives me bonkers. Like, I'm not even kidding you. I spent hours today trying to relearn how to do this. I mean, I actually knew how to do this before because a member of the Audiobus forum, the main forum for iOS app-related discussion, a member there called Samu posted a video a while ago. Thing is, the video was incredibly fast, and I think I kept just missing some aspects of it, so I'm making this one with a mouse, which I think will be a lot more accessible to people. So we're going to look at the process here, and I think you'll agree with me that this is really genuinely a needlessly convoluted process. It really drives me bonkers, but I do like this app very much. It's only $2. It's a great app. I recommend getting it. But I really dislike the way this works for this kind of thing. So we click on these three dots up here first. So the first thing we're going to do is create a folder within which AUv3 files will be saved. So we click here on export/import, and then we click over here, export to WAVs. Now, then you have to look down at the bottom of the screen and select edit, and then you have to choose create directory. And then if you want to give this directory a name, you have to click here. And I'm just going to call it just Gav. Okay, and so I've just typed in Gav, all lowercase here. And then I'm going to press OK. And now I need to press OK again. And now this part is very unintuitive, I think. So then you have to click on this so that that becomes written up here with a slash after it. And now finally you're ready to click OK here. So I clicked OK there. Now we're back in the app. So now we have to click on these three dots again. Click here on export, import. Click on system export. OK, click back here. Now here, you have to tap on this and you have to write in the name of the file again. And again, if you know a better way to do this, let me know, please. And then here, click OK. And now the files dialog opens up and just choose where you want to save it. So I'm just going to save it in downloads and I'm just going to press save. And you can see down here, it just says Gav. And that is saved. And now if I go to files, and I click on downloads, we see here we have this folder Gav, and inside it we have our files. So that is just not a pleasure for me. It's incredibly unintuitive. I'll just mention while I'm at it, another little observation. The BPMs in this app, like here there's a little slider to adjust the BPM. Now normally, AUv3s, if we change the BPM in the host app, so here I'm using AUM, and I've got a whole video about 40 minutes long on how to use this, by the way, if you're not familiar with it and want to know this, how to use this really popular iOS mixer slash host app. Normally, if we change the BPM here, this would also change the BPM that this AUv3 is running at. But unfortunately, they're not synced. So like, for example, if I just change that BPM there, it's not changing the BPM here. And if I change the BPM here, it's not changing it here. So I don't know if that's just a bug or what, but really it would be ideal if they were synced. And then again, correct me if I'm wrong, another Audiobus forum member, world's second best geo shredder, brought up a point that I think is very valid. There doesn't seem to be any way to adjust the pitch of individual sounds here. Because, you know, you might want to just adjust the pitch of one and not adjust the pitch of others, but that just doesn't seem to be possible. So I think that would be great if that could be added. Maybe like over here, there could be some kind of little setting for adjusting the pitch of whatever slice you've selected. I'll also just mention one more thing. So there's a lock function. And again, some of these things are a little bit unintuitive. So I might mess this up. You know, the thing is, normally I just prefer to, you know, use external MIDI to send into this. But if you do want to play it inside the app itself, you might want to lock certain sounds. So like, let's say, let me see if I do this right. So if I press that, no, let me press lock first. Okay, so I've pressed lock and now I can just choose some of these. Now you can see that several get selected because it's the same sound at different octaves, okay? So yeah, there are basically 12 different sounds generated. And then when you play up here, you know, it's going to be higher one, lower, and another octave lower. So that's what the lock function does. And let me just unpress lock there. And so now you can see these have this little white triangle there and they are now locked. So what that means is that if we press this, for example, to randomize another bunch of sounds, these ones that are locked will not be randomized. So you can see, like, look at that one, look what it looks like. You see how it stays the same, right? Now, there's another thing as well, And that is about if you want to play on the touchscreen here. And so this is obviously going to be useful if you're using the standalone and you don't have a little keyboard, say, inside your host like I do here in AUM. So let's say I press this one. Or let me just choose a different one. Okay, let's take this. So do you see now how down here, this has changed to hold? So if I press hold here, I have to hold that, and then I take my finger off this pad, and now that is held. So again, let's look at that. So I'm going to press here, and then I'm going to go down here and tap hold, and now I can remove my finger. Oh no, not correct, hang on. Oh yeah, so I have to tap hold, and then I remove my finger, and then I remove, first I remove my finger from the pad, and then I remove it from the hold button, which I'm still holding at the moment. Okay, so now those are held. So let's just try that again. Again, just not very intuitive. So you can see also, although these might be synced by certain BPM, you're going to have to press. You're going to have to experiment sometimes with pressing things at the right time that your rhythms are going to line up. So let's press hold, and then I take my finger off the pad, and then I take my finger off the hold button. Now that's changed to lock again, and this is held. I suppose we may as well just go through a couple of other functions. So you have this stereo setting here, and you have reverb here. And echo here, and you can tap on things to enter certain values, by the way, if you want. You just double tap. And then here, this interpolation. Zero is more lo-fi sounding, basically. And one somewhere in between, then two is a bit more high-res. You can hear it more noticeably with certain types of sound. Okay, you can hear it pretty clearly there. That's interpolation zero, that's one, and that's two. Now, if I want to unhold these, I just tap them, and then they will be released. If we want to unlock things, just press lock and select again, and that will now be unlocked. So definitely, it really takes some getting used to the way some things are implemented here, but very cool app. You know, I really like this developer's apps, so I don't want to be too critical, but honestly, it really, really wound me up, like having to spend so much time to figure out how to do something so simple. And there is no detailed information in the manual about that. I looked at the Sunvox manual, and that had some instructions about doing these kind of things, but those seemed even more convoluted than this way. I don't know, I tried following them, and I just wasn't really getting the results I was hoping for. So, yeah. Although I like this app, and it's just $2 and it's well worth getting, there's room for some improvement, particularly in regard to exporting all the sounds on the screen in one go when you're using the AUv3. All right, everyone. I hope that was useful for you. Smash the like, etc. if it was. and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.